Hello, I'm Bill.
I'm Jessica.
I'm Josh.
And we're the leaders of Celebrate Recovery.
We would just want to tell y'all a little bit about Celebrate Recovery. It's so much more than drugs and alcoholism. Celebrate Recovery is for all of life's habits, hurts, and hang-ups. In fact, only one in every three people come to Celebrate Recovery for drug and alcohol addiction nationwide.
And today we have a few short testimonies to share with you.
There I was, empty-handed, crying out from the pit of my despair.
My name is Anthony, and I'm a firm believer in Jesus Christ who struggled with chemical addiction.
Hey, my name is Paula, and I want to share what God has done for me. But I have a story that probably a lot of people don't know about me. My story is about depression, anxiety, and panic disorder.
Coming up, I had an awesome family. Mom and Dad both worked hard to provide for my brothers and I. It was three of us. And whatever we seemed like we wanted or needed or anything, we got. So as life went on, it was gravy until this one day. My mom disappeared. We didn't see her anymore. So we had to go stay with our grandmother. And that was one of the hardest times that I ever faced in the 45 years I've been on this earth. And it was the start of my destruction, of going down the wrong path.
A few years ago, actually in December 2012, I became very ill with some physical problems. And at that point, I became so ill that I had to walk away from a job that I'd had for 22 years. My illness was physical and basically turned emotional. I guess I'd had some depression, a big part of my life, but nothing that I couldn't control.
And so every chance I got to deal with all the pain and struggles I was going through, I turned to alcohol. It was one of the worst times of my life, turning to alcohol, trying to substitute for the pain. And I was drinking and drinking until when you're drinking and you get drunk, then it's too late. Because once you realize you're drunk, it's a lot more coming behind it. And so I was clubbing, doing a whole lot of clubbing in Alma, my hometown. And I walked in the bathroom and some guys was in there doing cocaine. And so I asked the guys, I said, man, how'd that make you feel? Let me hit that. And the guys, one of the guys begged me not to try it. But me, living in the streets, the street life, I tried it anyway. I convinced them to let me try it. And at the time, it was a great feeling. But man, I tell you, the effect it had on the long run, I started living a real fast lane then. Couldn't tell me nothing. You couldn't tell her nothing. And finally, God told me, he said, that's enough.
Depression and anxiety and panic attacks took over to the point that I couldn't function anymore. I couldn't drive. I shut myself up at the house and probably for the first 6 months didn't even stay in the bed, didn't do anything. One morning, as always, when I'd open up my eyes, I'd be depressed and I began to seek God. And God told me at that moment, if you will come to me first, then I'll work everything else out.
There you were in the shadows, holding out your hand, you made me there.
But by the grace of God, he allowed me to call out on his name while I was in prison. After I found out my way wasn't working, that I wasn't going to get out until it was God's timing. And so I finally surrendered to him and got on my knees one night and just cried my little heart out to him and told the Lord, I said, Lord, I can't do it. Please get me out of here. I need your help. I can't do this alone. I said, I surrender to you right now, Lord. And so he heard my cry.
I finally began to come out of my shell some, and one day, while I was reading the Bible, and I was reading out of 1 Kings, I believe it is, about Elijah. When Elijah was running from the armies of Jezebel, he was in the cave. And this story actually began to become part of what God was showing me. What God told me was, I want you to get up. He said, I didn't put you here. What are you doing here? And he says, it's time to go back to church. Anyway, we went back to church. We visited several other churches, but we went back to our church we'd been a member of for 30 years, 30 some odd years. And then one day we were invited to Remnant. And story goes is we've been here ever since. And I always tell everybody, and I believe it with all my heart, that God led us here.
If you're dealing with any kind of addiction, it doesn't have to be drugs or alcohol or anything. It's any kind of addiction, whatever it may be. If you got an addiction, try Celebrate Recovery here at Remnant, and it will change your life.
Don't be alone, because when you're alone, you suffer alone, and it just makes it worse. But I just encourage you that there is a way back. I've learned now how to find my help, and my help comes from God. He's still working on me, but I know how to search for Him now when this happens. And my motto is that I can't tell you about me without telling you about God.
And now where would I be without you? Where would I be, Jesus? You were the voice in the desert, calling me out in the dead of night.
I'd like to thank God right now amongst everyone. If y'all out there doing drugs, if you're doing wrong, please stop. Turn to God, man. He is waiting for you. And if you don't backslid, don't be scared to surrender. Don't be scared of what God's going to do for you. He's going to hate you. He will never hate you. He will never leave you nor forsake you. All you got to do is call upon His name and know that He is God, and He will help you.